It's Claire. I'm so happy you stopped by. Today I have a review and a demo on the Clinique Even Better SPF 15 foundation. Before I get into the foundation, I wanted to talk about how I even got introduced to this foundation. Anytime I am planning on buying a high-end foundation, it's always a premeditated decision. I always do a lot of research beforehand. But with this guy, it was a complete impulse buy. And that's why I wanted to do a review on it and let you guys know how I found out about it. I know it's been in the makeup beauty realm for a long time, but I'm new to it. And when I went to Sephora about 3 days ago, I went with the intention of buying one product, and of course that never happens. I learned that Sephora just came out with the Pantone Color IQ machine, and the Sephora makeup artist asked me if I wanted to try the machine out. It's a little handheld machine, and talk about advanced technology. She sat me down and scanned my face in about three areas, and within 10 seconds, she told me my face number, which was 3Y07, and it pulled up every foundation shade of mine in each brand of Sephora. So what we did was look through all my shades in each brand. I looked to see which one was most suitable to me, and this is what stuck out. It was the Clinique Even Better foundation. But I was most curious to see how accurate the color was that it suggested for me, so I had the makeup artist try it on me right there in the store. It was such an accurate match, and I fell in love with the way this Clinique foundation looked. So I'm gonna link more information about that machine in the description box. It's absolutely phenomenal. Now I have a whole page emailed to me about what foundation I am in each brand. So it's super cool, it's super advanced, and it's just going to rock your world. So that is what led me to this Clinique Even Better SPF 15 foundation, and it said I was in the shade Golden Neutral number 16. This product comes in 30 shades, so it's very catering to all skin tones, which is a huge bonus. That's something I always look for, especially being a makeup artist myself. If I'm interested in purchasing more of the foundations, I like to know that they have a lot of variety from that certain brand. So it comes in packaging like this. It is one of the smallest foundations I own. The amount of product in it is, it's one fluid ounce and then 30 milliliters of product. Just seems like it's a little bit smaller than a lot of my other ones. So the catch is a little bit goes a long way. I have found that. Clinique claims it's going to do is that it's going to even and correct the look of your skin over a course of time. So essentially this is very similar to a BB cream. It's gonna give coverage, but also going to help brighten and get rid of any sort of discoloration your skin might have over a period of time, which is great, I think, if you can find a foundation with coverage and something that's going to be beneficial to your skin. That's kind of like hitting jackpot. So that was a huge, huge selling point for me with this product, because I love my BB creams. And so I'm just going to demo this out for you guys. As you can see, it has like a little spout like this, and you just squeeze it out to get the product out. Kind of reminds me of one of those arts and crafts, kind of like glues or like the paints that you dispense out with. So I only start out with a little amount here, and I found that I like using it the best either with my fingers or with, I like always using a synthetic brush like the Samantha Chapman Real Techniques brush. So I'm going to pick that up on the back of my hand, and I'm going to start with this on one side of my face so we can see the difference. The fragrance is very subtle. You can hardly smell the foundation. It's nothing that is unbearable or anything. And it's very creamy, so you're gonna see that it applies very smoothly to the skin. I have just moisturizer on right now, so that also helps with any liquid foundation to blend it into your skin. So I do have dark spots on the side of my face, so I do want you guys to see how it covers any sort of dark spots or kind of acne scarring. Focus it right underneath the eye as well, and it just blends so smoothly. That's what I really liked about it. Go on the eyelids. So just to show you guys, this side of my face has the Clinique Even Better foundation on it. As you can see, it does provide some shine, so it does have that radiant look to your skin. So if you have dry skin like me and you don't mind that kind of finish, then this is a really nice foundation if you like that. Also, I want you guys to see that it covers, it's about a medium coverage. It doesn't fully cover my dark spots here, but I'm curious to see. I want to add a little bit more on this area. I'm going to build on it and see how it does. So I'm picking up a little more foundation and going to build right on top. I always like to press on top. If you are layering it, you just want to press right on top of any sort of spots you're trying to cover. I'd say it does a decent job of disguising those dark spots. It's not going to completely transform your skin, so I wouldn't anticipate buying this if you're looking for a full coverage. It's definitely more of a medium coverage. I think it's a great foundation more for daily wear. And I'm going to continue applying the rest to the other side of the face. So here is what the Clinique Even Better foundation looks like all over my face. As you can see, the camera is definitely picking up the shine that it provides. Again, it's not going to be a full coverage foundation, as you can see on some of my acne scars here, but I do think it's a great foundation for dry skin. I think it's a great foundation for daily wear. It's a foundation that's definitely going to need a little bit of a powder because it is so dewy, and it will have the tendency to slip a little bit if you don't set it in. Like any liquid foundation, always good to set a powder to ensure the longevity of your face makeup. Also, it is very much channeling a BB cream right now. The way it feels, the way it was applied, I love BB cream, so if you're a big BB cream, lover, definitely sample this out and see what you think. First thing I thought after putting this on is that not only is it great to have youthful looking skin, but I think mature skin women would really like this foundation. It doesn't sit into the lines. It's so moisturizing, and it gives really nice natural coverage. I think if you have mature skin, you would really like this foundation as well. That's why I think this is such a bonus foundation, that it's very catering, not only in its shades, but I think young to mature skin can wear this foundation and it's going to look really nice on you. It is very photography friendly. It's going to look really nice in pictures. So if it's your wedding coming up, or if you're looking for a good foundation for bridal makeup, this one is definitely a good possibility. That is something that I always look for. Can I use this foundation on my clients? So thumbs up to that as well. Overall, I am very pleased with this foundation. If you guys have tried it out, please let me know. And I hope you guys test out the Sephora Color IQ machine. It is so cool. I will link that below. I'll also link this Clinique Even Better foundation below. I hope you guys enjoyed this review. Let me know what you think, and I look forward to using it in tutorials in the future. So I hope you guys are having a great day, and I look forward to seeing you all next time. Take care. Bye-bye.